Good morning. Welcome to worship today. I'm glad to see all of you here. I especially want to welcome visitors that are here. We always ask members and visitors to sign the little friendship registers and then pass them along in your pew so that we know with whom we're worshiping today. It's a very special Sunday today because we are going to celebrate the sacrament of baptism for little Sarah Westman. And so I can't wait to get my hands on her. Also today is a peanut butter and jelly sandwich day. So if you have time after church and can lend a hand for our peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, we make 300 of them, and they are given to the homeless so that they have at least another meal after they've been to either the Salvation Army or the rescue mission in Atlantic City. Yesterday, unfortunately, was a very sad day for our church. We said goodbye to Mary Lou Adams Crimbering. We had a wonderful memorial service here in the sanctuary to celebrate her life, but it was still a very sad day for us to say goodbye to such a long time and active member of our church. We have quite a bit going on this week. On Monday evening, please make note, trustees, the trustee meeting is on Monday this month instead of Tuesday, so please make a note of that tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. On Wednesday at 7 o'clock, the chancel choir will rehearse. On Friday evening, we have a wedding rehearsal for Randy Clark and Chantel Myers. That's Joe and Susan Clark's son. So this is a very, very special wedding next weekend, and the service is on Saturday at 3 o'clock. Also, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday this coming week, the Full Moon Theater is giving their production of The Miracle Worker, and it should be a wonderful production. I even hear there's a doggie in it. So I was asked to give permission for that, and I said, I'm a dog lover. You have my permission. Also, the following weekend, we do it again. The show is at 7:30 on Friday and Saturday evening, and then matinee at 2 o'clock. Please, everybody, this is the last week for Best of the Press. So please get your votes in every day this week for best place of worship, best wedding person, me, best nursery school, and best live theater. So please get your votes in, and we might have a shot again at it this year. And now let us listen to the introit as we begin our worship.
Good morning. Please join me in the call to worship printed in your bulletin. We are the people of God. We are the body of Christ gathered around the table. We are the community of faith strengthened for life here and beyond these doors. Let us worship God.
Our opening hymn is number 369, Blessed Assurance.
Oh.
Please join me in the prayer, again found in your bulletin. Merciful God, you search our hearts and you know us from the beginning of life. You see more good and beauty in us that we have dared to believe. You call us by name and beckon us to do more than we have dared to try. Shine your light into our hesitancy. Embolden us to live with such joy and enthusiasm that the world around us will know of your love through us. Use our hands and arms and words so that we may be partners with you in this world. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
And now I'd like to invite the children to come forward and sit on that side of the church, and also the baptism family to come forward, Morgan and David and little Sarah, and the godparents can come up. Friends, hear the words of our Lord Jesus. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey all things that I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you even to the end of the age. Obeying the words of our Lord Jesus and confident of his promises, we baptize those whom God has called. In baptism, God claims us and seals us to show that we belong to God. God frees us from sin and death and unites us with Jesus Christ. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are made members of the church, the body of Christ, and joined to Christ's ministry of love, peace, and justice. Let us remember with joy our own baptism as we celebrate this sacrament. Now, I'm going to ask questions of the grown-ups here in a minute, and I'd like to ask questions of the little folks here, because it's just as important for you to make promises to little Sarah, okay? So, if you ever see Sarah crying, will you try to comfort her? Oh, thank you, okay. And if you see that she fell down, will you help her to get up? And if you see that she's lost, will you help her find her mommy and daddy? Okay, thank you. And now I'm going to ask questions of the grown-ups. Do you reaffirm your faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, do you? And relying on God's grace, do you promise to live that faith and teach that faith to your daughter? Okay, and to the sponsors. Do you promise by prayer and example to support and encourage Sarah to be a faithful Christian? And to the congregation, do you, as members of the Church of Jesus Christ, promise to nurture and guide little Sarah by word and deed with love and prayer, encouraging her to know and love and follow Christ and be a faithful member of Christ's church? Do you? Let us pray. Eternal and gracious God, we give you thanks. In countless ways, you have revealed yourself in ages past and have blessed us with signs of your grace through water and the Spirit. In the beginning, your Spirit hovered over the dark deep. From this formless void, you brought forth light and life. By the waters of the flood, you cleaned the world and made with Noah and his family a new beginning for all people. In the time of Moses, you led your people out of slavery through the waters of the sea, making a covenant with them in a new land. At the appointed time in the waters of the Jordan, when Jesus was baptized by John, you sent your Spirit upon him. Now, by the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, Christ sets us free from sin and death and opens the way to eternal life. Pour out your Spirit upon us and upon this water, that it may be a fountain of deliverance and rebirth for Sarah. May all who pass through these waters be delivered from death to life, from bondage to freedom, from sin to righteousness, and new life in you. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen. By what name shall this child be called? We want to be in a place where we can see mommy. I can tell that. Sarah Marie, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, uphold Sarah by your Spirit. Give her the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of joy in your presence both now and forever. Sarah Marie, child of the covenant, you have been sealed by the Spirit and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. That is so powerful. It almost makes me cry. This little girl is very special to me because I feel like I had something to do with it. I married her mommy and daddy in 2019. And this is the result. And we are so pleased that she's here this morning to be baptized. And these are your new family members, Sarah. These are all family in Christ. And we have given you a new last name after Westman, and that is the last name of Christian. And we all have that last name after we have been baptized. So this is a very, very special day for you. And for all of us. So now I will give her back.
So good. Might have you too.
There we go. Let us pray. Merciful God, you call each of us by name and promise us your constant love. We have baptized Sarah in your name and sealed her identity in you. Watch over this little one, and as the years go by, deepen her understanding of your love. Gracious God, we pray for Morgan and David and parents everywhere. Give them wisdom and patience to guide their children in the way of Jesus Christ. Let your peace and joy dwell in their home, that their family life may be instructed by faith, sustained by prayer, and governed by love. This morning, Lord God, we rejoice with you that Sarah will always know who she is, that as she faces the mysteries of life, she will always remember that she is yours. For this very day, she was baptized. We pray your blessing on her and on the life that awaits her. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Now, I have a little something here for you both. There's her baptism certificate and a little pink rose to memorize the day. And now go to love and serve the Lord. You can sit down and you guys can go to Sunday school. And if any of the other children here want to go to nursery or Sunday school, these two guys know where it all is. And now let us sing the baptism hymn. Just verses 1 and 3 of number 608.
Oh,
Let us say our affirmation of faith together. As one people, with one voice, we affirm our faith in God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer of all that is, from frozen Arctic ice caps to flowering desert cacti, from microbes and quarks to vast galaxies. God intricately knit our universe together. The laws of physics and mathematics, the multiplicity of languages and cultures, the precision of our bodies, the wealth of wisdom, scientists, philosophers, artists, and dreamers speak of the awesome power, incomparable intelligence, and the unfathomable mystery of God. This is the God who loves us. This is the God we were made to enjoy. This is the God we serve. All glory and praise to God. Amen.
Thanks. As we come to our time of prayer, I'd like to remind you of some of our concerns of our family of faith. We are continuing prayers for Dave McCann, Ken Heck, Neil Gamble, Lexi and her family, Carl, Lynn Daly's stepdaughter Pat, Lanny Walter, a little girl recovering from a stem cell transplant. We're praying for Audrey Owen, who is in Shore Memorial Hospital. We're praying for Steve Jacoby, who is at Excel Rehab Center on Delilah Road in Egg Harbor Township. He had a compound fracture of his wrist, but he's getting therapy for walking and strength. We're praying for his grandson, Kevin, for Nancy Swartz's grandson, Dylan, for Bob Garbutt, who had injured his leg very badly. We're praying for Carl Ekstrom, Linda Donovan's mother, Gladys, and her friends, Michelle and Don. We're praying for Jenny Beck's friend, Kathy, and stepdaughter, Deborah. Nancy Young's cousin Marilyn, who's having cancer treatment, Ricky Knight, son of Tom and Ann Klein, who is facing surgery, Elaine McLathery, her friend Dina is having surgery, she's recovering, and Mary, who needs to have surgery, and we're praying for Sonia Bertini's niece, Nora. The surgery that she had didn't work as well as expected, and so she has to have a second surgery. How old is she, Sonia?
One and a half.
One and a half, yeah. So we want to put our prayers there. Are there any other joys or concerns to share? Yes. I'm sorry, I couldn't hear.
The Beisler family.
The Beisler family? Okay.
Craig Scheller.
Craig Scheller. Let's join our hearts and minds in prayer. Let us pray. God of all creation, we worship and adore you. The wonders of your wisdom and power surround us in all that we see. From the tiniest insect to the largest animal, we see your loving work. In all of creation, we see you working to bring all things to fulfillment. We thank you for the wondrous gifts you have bestowed upon us. We thank you for our world, our lives, and our loved ones. We thank you for food and shelter. Most of all, we thank you for Jesus Christ and his message of grace as you come to renew and reclaim us in the waters of baptism. Almighty God, we pray for our world that needs your healing, peace, and truth. Lead those in power to seek peace and pursue it so that all your children may dwell in safety. We pray for the Church Universal, where all of your children are invited to be part of your family. We ask your special blessing on little Sarah and her parents, Morgan and David, this day. And we thank you for the gift of baptism for each of us, where we are marked and sealed as Christ's own forever. Be with our church here in Margate. May we continue to grow in grace. Bless the works of love that are done in your name here in our church family and around the world. Help us to know that what we give in time, talents, and treasures
is letting the world know of your great love. We have many concerns and worries. You have heard the ones of our church family here this morning. We know that you desire to heal and renew those in need. We offer now to you silently those who are on our hearts and minds this day. Grant us your peace. May we all feel anew your presence with us here in this place and later as we go to our homes for rest or recreation. We pray all these things in the strong and powerful name of Jesus, who taught us all to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Let us continue our worship by presenting our tithes, our gifts, and our offerings.
Let us pray. We come to this place, O God, and give in gratitude for all that we have received. We give not because we pledge to and not because we have to. We give in response to the life of Christ given for us. We give in joy because of love overflowing and unconditional. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated. Our scripture passage this morning is from the Psalms. This is only a portion of Psalm 66. It's quite a long psalm. We're not sure who wrote all the psalms. It's by tradition, people say it was King David who wrote all of the psalms, but it seems kind of doubtful that he did all of them. Certainly some feel like they pertain to certain areas of his life and his life story, but others are psalms of praise. And this one is certainly a psalm of praise. So listen for God's word to you this morning. Shout joyful praises to God, all the earth. Sing about the glory of his name. Tell the world how glorious he is. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. Your enemies cringe before your mighty power. Everything on earth will worship you. They will sing your praises, shouting your name in glorious songs. Come and see what God has done, what awesome miracles he performs for people. He made a dry path through the Red Sea, and his people went across on foot. There we rejoiced in him, for by his great power he rules forever. He watches every movement of the nations. Let no rebel rise in defiance. Let the whole world bless our God and loudly sing his praises. Our lives are in his hands, and he keeps our feet from stumbling. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Will you pray with me? O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. The Grand Canyon, a hurricane, the Hallelujah Chorus, a sunrise over the ocean, a sunset over the bay, the birth of a baby, Abraham Lincoln, Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela. Connect the dots, and what do you get? A sense of awe. Each of these persons or events has the power to give us goosebumps. Awe comes from being overwhelmed by greatness. We feel it when we watch the storm waves crash on the beach, when we cower in the basement during a hurricane. Well, wait a minute, that's wrong. Scratch that one. We don't have basements here on the island. We hit water right away. But other people, you know. When we rise to our feet during the Hallelujah Chorus, or look up at the Milky Way at night, or witness the birth of a baby. We even feel it when we encounter the steadfastness of an Abraham Lincoln, the love of a Mother Teresa, the dedication of Nelson Mandela. Now, when I was a little girl, I had my first encounter with goosebumps. So let me set this up for you. Every year, my cousin would come down to our house in Ventnor. She lived the rest of the year in Philadelphia, where she went to school and her parents worked. Summers in Ventnor worked out like a win-win for everybody. We were both only children. Our mothers were sisters, but we were alone most of the year, and so we had this wonderful playmate built in the summertime. And her parents were happy to have the child care during the week. My mom's house was on South Harvard Avenue, and it had a sun porch that had three sides of big, tall windows. When there was a thunderstorm, my cousin and I couldn't wait to see all the lightning strikes, and that gave us goosebumps. Now,
sometimes those lightning strikes would give us the goosebumps and we were thrilled, but you need to know also that I was a church girl, so to speak. My parents and I went to church every single week. The church we went to was right around the corner from our house, St. John's by the Sea on Sacramento Avenue. And we went to church twice on Sundays, believe it or not. There was a morning service and then Sunday school that included adults. And then we went to a service at night. And just to let you know, I hated the nighttime service. I was given a reprieve when the Beatles came on Ed Sullivan. I didn't have to go that night. Anyway, as I said, we were always at church, and to me, a thunderstorm spoke of God's power. God was saying, I am huge, I am powerful, but I'm still here for you. And one time, though, God was a little too powerful and too huge. A lightning bolt struck our backyard. My cousin and I saw this round orange bolt hit the backyard. Of course, that it's accompanied immediately with the crash of thunder, and we had no goosebumps. We screamed, and I'm not sure if we ever watched another thunderstorm from that room. But anyway, I'll be honest. I get goosebumps if I hear a band play the Star Spangled Banner. I loved listening to it during the Olympics. It was great. Now, I must say, though, I don't enjoy always a singer who adds a lot of other notes and then goes flat on the rocket's great glare, but that's beside the point. I just had goosebumps this past Wednesday, right here in this building. Jenny will attest to this. Carmela and Jenny and I were reminiscing, so to speak, about where we were when we heard about 9/11/2001. And I think we all had goosebumps as we thought about that powerful day. Goosebumps are our body telling us that what we're seeing or experiencing is something of greatness that we've maybe never seen before. Unfortunately, I don't think we're experiencing the awe of goosebumps that much these days. Many of us are disgusted with some of our current politicians, and they certainly do not fill us with awe, sometimes the opposite. And think about it. We spend more time looking down at our smartphones than we do looking at the stars in the sky. Our ears are filled with the noise of life, daily life, which drowns out the notes of beautiful music that can surprise us. I think delight us too, and lift our spirits. We want the gift of goosebumps, but it's getting harder and harder to find. The writer of Psalm 66 points us to God, the most awe-inspiring of all powers. How awesome are your deeds, exclaims the psalm writer. Because of your great power, your enemies cringe before you. The psalm correctly identifies an important component of awe, and that is fear. This is probably true because even non-human mammals get goosebumps when they face a threat. That's because in the presence of a predator, the muscles surrounding hair follicles contract. We humans get goosebumps when we're scared, but also when we experience awe. Fear and awe are very closely connected. And maybe that's why the Bible speaks so often of the fear of the Lord. This fear comes from standing in or just being in the presence of Almighty God and seeing or feeling something we have never seen or felt before. We're not supposed to be frightened of God, but instead to feel that tremendous awe and respect. Much as we might stand in awe of the incredible power of a hurricane or marvel at the immensity of the Grand Canyon. All of us get goosebumps. The Bible makes it clear that God is both mighty and good, and we as God's people are to stand in awe and worship. Have you ever read the C.S. Lewis book, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe? If you don't know, C.S. Lewis was a Christian writer, and in a sense, God is very much like the Aslan the Lion character in that book. In the story, a little girl named Susan asks Mr. Beaver if Aslan the Lion is safe. She says she's a little nervous about meeting a lion for the first time. And Mr. Beaver replies, "Safe? Who said anything about safe? Of course he isn't safe, but he's good. He's the king." And in a sense, we can think of God like Aslan, because Aslan wasn't safe, but he was good. God isn't safe, but God is good. God can give us goosebumps. God, the Almighty King, inspires us with awe and makes us want to worship. God is mighty and good. And notice that the praise of Psalm 66 is connected to both God's character and God's accomplishments. The Bible says, "Come and see what God has done. He is awesome in the miracles he performs for people." The mighty acts of God are what inspire the greatest awe and praise. God created the world out of nothing and said it was good. God liberated the people from slavery and they walked through the Red Sea on dry land. God sent his Son into the world so that everyone that believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. In every time and place, God is awesome in his deeds. Goosebump inspiring. Again and again, Psalm 66 speaks of God bringing life out of death and working for the deliverance of his people. And that's why sometimes this psalm is called the Psalm of the Resurrection. Resurrection is the ultimate goosebump giver. The four gospel writers, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, all end their narrations of Jesus' life with the account of Jesus' resurrection. They come at it from different directions, and there's some different details in each one. But one element that is common to all of them is the element of surprise. Now, even though the resurrection was hinted at in the Old Testament scripture, and Jesus, in fact, said it himself three times in the New Testament, everybody that was around him were surprised. The first people that were around him after the resurrection were only thinking about the death before they could get the surprise and the goosebumps of the resurrection. Now, here's the surprising benefit of being part of a group of people who stand in awe of God. It's this: it makes us better people. According to research that was reported in the New York Times, awe motivates people to do things that enhance the greater good. Many activities can give us goosebumps, from music to worship, and help us to shift the focus from ourselves to the interests of others. Researchers have found that people who experience more awe in their lives are generous to strangers, cooperate more, share more resources, and sacrifice more for others. Who knew that awe would inspire the Margate Community Church to make peanut butter and jelly sandwiches? Seriously. According to one source, awe gives people a different sense of themselves, one that is smaller and more humble by being part of something bigger than themselves. Our God is truly an awesome God, and we are privileged to be part of an awesome community that he has created. So experience more awe. Seek out the things that give you goosebumps. Crank up the hallelujah chorus. Take a walk on the beach. Read a book about miracles. Instead of being awe deprived, your awe will turn you into a better person. As Christians, our challenge is to make a joyful noise to the Lord and to remember the awesomeness of God's deeds. As we do this, we'll become more focused on other people than on ourselves. Our songs of praise will give us the gift of goosebumps, But more importantly, they'll give us the gift of a better relationship with God and each other. Will you pray with me? Lord, you are truly an awesome God. If we just open our eyes, we will see all that you have done and will do. Help us to remember who we really are in the vast scheme of life, and then to turn that into actions that make us your partners in this world. Thank you for loving us, adopting us in the waters of baptism, and saving us through the Lord Jesus. We pray in his name. Amen. And now please join me in hymn number 101, our final hymn, verses 1, 2, and 4.
Today, please know that we have coffee hour after church in Fellowship Hall, and also the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches will be made in there. So if you have some time and slather some bread, that would be a great help. And now go find some goosebumps so that you can be a better person and remember that God is awe-inspiring. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship, strength, and peace of the Holy Spirit be with you and with all those whom you love today and forever. Amen.